This is how to plan your shot of the partial solar eclipse that occurs on September 21st or 22nd, depending on where you are on Earth. Step by step. To plan the eclipse, I'm going to use the PhotoPills planner, so tab on planner. And here, the first thing you need to do is to switch on the eclipse information on the map. So tap on the map settings button here, tap on the eclipse layer, and choose the eclipse you wish to plan. In this case, we're going for the September 21st, 2025 partial solar eclipse. So tap on this one and go back to the map. Now, zoom out to see where the eclipse is visible. In this case, the eclipse is visible in Antarctica and in New Zealand. Pretty cool. But don't worry, if you're not in these areas, you can just travel to catch the eclipse there. But you're gonna learn in this video, it will help you plan any other solar eclipse that is approaching. And next year, we have quite a few. So now place the red pin in the spot you wish to photograph the eclipse. For example, if you go to Antarctica, you can just place it here, for example. That's awesome. And now swipe the top panels to the left until you get to the eclipse panel to see all the faces of the eclipse. You have the times of the faces of the eclipse on the top panel. And as you see, as I change the time using the time bar, you can see on the top panel the picture of the eclipse as it evolves throughout the time. And on the panel, you have the time each phase of the eclipse begins, when the partial begins, when it's maximum, and when it ends. And on the map, you have the direction where the eclipse will occur, which is this thin kind of purple line that's moving when I change the time. Actually, here in Antarctica, the eclipse will set eclipsed. It's pretty cool. The eclipse occurs at sunset. That's awesome. Now, if you wish to locate the eclipse in the sky, you can always use the AR button here and visualize where the eclipse will occur. As you see, it's occurring at sunset in Antarctica, which is pretty cool. So you have the times of the phase of the eclipse on the top panel. You have where the eclipse will occur using the map lines and the AR. And on the time bar, you have the date. In this case, in Antarctica, it's on September 21st. And the time, 6:16 p.m., which is when the eclipse is maximum in this case. Pretty cool. If you go to New Zealand, you'll see that the eclipse is completely different. We can go to Wellington, for example, here. And you see that in New Zealand, the eclipse occurs at sunrise. The sun will rise eclipse, which is pretty cool. And the eclipse is much larger, so the moon covers much more of the sun's disk, which is amazing. Okay, so now you have everything you need to plan your eclipse shot. You know when it occurs and where you need to go to plan it and where the sun will be during the eclipse at all times, so you can choose your shooting spot, for example, to align the eclipse with an interesting subject. Oh my God, I wish I could go to Antarctica or New Zealand to photograph this amazing eclipse. What do you think? Would you like to be there? Let me know in the comments. And now you still learn more on how to plan and photograph this amazing eclipse. I invite you to download our super detailed solar eclipse photography guide. I'm gonna leave a link to the guide in the description of this video and in the first column below. Download it. And as always, if you like this video, give me a like, subscribe, and I'll see you next Wednesday in another video. And remember, that you have the power to imagine, plan, and shoot legendary photos. Bye.